I guess you could, you know, you could make a case for that. But this is really not you know, Couchbase server is not really a web server per se. You know, that's the first thing, right? This is really only for the IP part.
I've never heard anybody offering a RESTful web API that doesn't use the standard transport code ports on the set because of the people blocking it.
No, that's not true. Because, you know, even if you look at Comcast and all that, right? You know, the admin console is on a different port. You know, usually it's not an 8080, right? You know, it's something like that.
Probably the front end of this guy. Just say, yeah.
Right. I'm sure you can configure it somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, you can definitely configure it. Exactly. Yeah, if you want it, you can configure it to any port.
But like, you know, those defaulting to 80 on Linux, you'd have to start it as root, right?
Yeah, so. Yeah, exactly. 8080, yeah, correct. So definitely possible. Okay, moving on. So this is kind of a workflow of, think of it as a key value pair right now. Okay, let's worry about JSON in a moment. Okay. But essentially what I do is that I set the value of a key. It goes to a particular server. One of the key things about Couchbase, and this is, you know, a differentiated thing from the other NoSQL databases, is that there is no such concept as a master slave. Okay, it's all, you know, everything is equal. Okay, which makes it kind of interesting. Okay, since, you know, if you have a master and slave, then you get into all kinds of other issues. Okay, but you know, since all nodes are created equal, essentially what happens is when I write to this particular node and I specify a replication factor which I can specify, you know, it can be anywhere from 1 to 3, meaning I want 1 replica to 3 replicas. So not just the key, but I can store it in, you know, in 3 different nodes, right? Couchbase replicates the key value pair, and it really stores the hard keys in memory and persists it to disk. You know, all of this happens behind the scenes. I don't really need to worry about any of those. Okay. If you want to realize, you know, if you want to find out if it really persisted to disk, you know, there are some APIs that are available. But really, I mean, a lot of times the application program doesn't even care. Yeah.
So how are you handling the simultaneous update in different nodes?
Yeah. So essentially, it's the onus of the application program. Really. Okay. We'll talk about that. You know, there's optimistic concurrency and there's pessimistic concurrency. One is, you know, you can grab a log and you can deal with it, right? Or there is something called as optimistic concurrency where you just go ahead and let it happen, okay? And when there is a collision, you may have to do something after that.
But even with optimistic blocking, you can end up in a distributed model where you have two people that updated at the same time.
Yes.